My brothers and sisters, without wasting too much of our time, we have before us salvation through sanctification by the Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Message we are sharing this hour, salvation through sanctification by the Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, you must be sanctified by the blood of Jesus Christ before you receive the salvation through the Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because salvation cannot come to you when you are not be sanctified by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ. This is the reason why the Lord Jesus Christ came to die. He came to die so that we can be washed by His blood, so that we will receive salvation. I mean, we will be saved. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And our Bible reading is taken from 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 13. And the Bible lets us to know, brothers and sisters, that it says that we are bound to give thanks to God, always for you, brethren, beloved by the Lord, because of God from the beginning, who choose you for salvation through the sanctification by the Spirit and believing in the truth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
To which He called you and I. He called you by the gospel for the obtaining of the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 13. Meaning, the Lord Jesus Christ, He has come to share His blood. Not like just a man taking a blood, a cow or a goat to a shrine and cut off his neck. After cutting off his neck, he have no effect that is useful. No. But the Lord Jesus Christ have come to share His blood on the cross, to sanctify His blood on the cross so that we might be saved, so that we might receive salvation. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, meaning the Bible is letting us to know, you and I, that God loves us so much. We are beloved by God. That we, He chose us. He chose you to be saved through the sanctification work of the Spirit, because we believe in the truth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He has called you. He has called you. Hallelujah. He has called you and I to this, through the gospel of truth, that you and I might be sharing in the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This is what the Lord is letting us to know this hour. The sanctification, you must be sanctified by the blood of Jesus Christ before you receive the salvation. Praise Master Jesus. You cannot receive salvation if anyone tells you that he is of a salvation when he have not been washed by the blood. Is lying, because you must receive Jesus. As you accept Jesus, then He washes you by His blood. Then salvation will come in. Without you washed by the blood of Jesus, you cannot receive salvation. This is what Jesus Christ has come to share in the cross. Not like just a man killing a goat on a shrine and he have no effect. He have no effect in useful. But Jesus make His own on the cross because He have effect. The effect is for we to be saved. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Brothers and sisters, this is what Jesus has come to do in our life. And the Bible lets us to know in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 2, it says, elect, according to the foreknowledge of God the Father, in sanctification of the Spirit, for obedience, in sprinkle of the blood of Jesus Christ, grace to you and peace being multiplied. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible is letting us to know that you and I, we have been chosen according to the word of God, the Father, through the sanctifying of the work of the Spirit, for obedience to Jesus Christ, for we to obey Jesus Christ, for obeying Jesus Christ and His blood, so that grace and peace will be yours, will be mine in abundance. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is what the Bible told us in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 2. This is what Lord Jesus Christ has done with His blood. That God has so much called His Son. What shall we do to the world? What do we need to do for them to be saved? And the son has to take up and move to the cross so that he might die. So that God has chosen us. He has already chosen us. What will he be saved? What will he make for we to be saved? It's for the sanctification, for we to be sanctified by the work of the Spirit, to obey Jesus Christ, to be obedient to Jesus Christ and his blood. But today, many of us are not obeying Jesus Christ. We are not even obeying his blood. We are no longer obeying the blood that Jesus shed in the cross of Calvary. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, this is what Jesus Christ has come to do in our life. He has come to do a great thing in your life, in my life. So what do we have to do then? For today, many of us are still dwelling in sin. We are still dwelling in sin. We don't know the reason and the purpose why Jesus Christ came to do a great thing in our life. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Brothers and sisters, the Bible says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 3 to 4, it says, for this, the will of God, you, I, sanctification, that you should accept from the sexual, absent from the sexual immorality. For that each of you shall know how to present your whole vessel in sanctification in an honor. Praise Master Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible is letting us to know that it is God's will, brothers and sisters, it is God's will that you shall be sanctified. I shall be sanctified. That you shall avoid sexual immorality. Hallelujah. That each of you shall learn to control his own body in a way that is holy and honorable to God. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This is what the Bible is telling us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 3 to 4. The Lord is letting us to know, but today, many of us does not see what Jesus has come for. The blood he has come to shed, is not even available to us. But I have come to understand that Jesus has come to do this just for a few. That is where we just read in Peter, the elect, the chosen one. There are people chosen by God. There are people Jesus has come to die for. Not everyone he comes to die for. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Because today, many people are still dwelling in sin. They are still dwelling in sin, not avoiding sin. But the Bible is letting us to know where we just read now, that is the will of God in our life, that we should be sanctified by the blood of Jesus Christ. This is why he called his son, come and help me to go and do this for them. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Come and help me to go so that you do this for me, so that they will be sanctified and avoid sexual immorality, because it's too much in the world. I don't want to come back again to destroy the world the way I did for the first time. Come and help me so that they will avoid fornication, adultery, evil. But today, they are still dwelling in evil. What a vampire, a generation of vampires again. You see, brothers and sisters, he's telling us, look at verse 4 very well, that each of you, each of us, shall learn, meaning we shall learn to control his own body. We shall control our own body away from and make our way to be holy and honorable to God, so that he be able to use us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are a vessel. We are a vessel. But today I've learned to know that there is a vessel for honor and a vessel for dishonor. Many people are made for a dishonor. Why, son? Let us not pray to be a vessel of a dishonor.
Amen.
Because we have no use for the work of the master. Only the vessel of honor that the master can be able to use for the work, for instrument.
Mm-hmm.
He can be able to use for a good work. He cannot use a dishonor vessel. May we not be a dishonor vessel in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But for we not to be these brothers and sisters, we must be very careful in the way of adultery, fornication, evil. Because they are out there. Those are property of Satan. We must avoid it. That is what the Lord is telling us. We must avoid it. Because it is in the God's will that we must be sanctified by the blood of Jesus Christ. This is why the Son came to share his blood. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Brothers and sisters, the Bible lets us to know in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 30, he said, He said, but of him that you are Christ Jesus, in Christ Jesus, who become for us wisdom from God, and righteousness, and sanctification, and redemption. Hallelujah. Amen. First Corinthians chapter 1, verse 13. In meaning, the Bible is letting us to know, it is because of him. Who is it? Because of what God has done. If you read very well, you see, God has seen how the world has become. He began to choose the foolish. The foolish one in the world.
Mm-hmm.
In this month today, the foolish people in the world, to create to the people that say they are wise. To create to them, to put them into shame, those that say they are wise.
Mm-hmm.
Today, many are out there thinking that they are wiser than God now that called them.
Mm-hmm.
But the Lord has called you and I that does not know anything. To make us to show to them, those that say they are wise, to show to them in the world, hallelujah, and call and choose the wicked one, those wicked things in the world, and put them to shame, those that say they are mighty, I mean those that say they are strong, to tell them they are not strong, they know nothing. This is who we are on this mountain today. The Lord has so called us, meaning that you and I, in Christ, today, we come to Christ, who have been, he has bring wisdom from God to us. That is our righteousness. Our righteousness and holiness to redeem us. To redeem us back home to God. This is what Jesus has come for. This is what the sanctification of his blood has come to do. To save us, to give us salvation through the Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Brothers and sisters, we are not taking much. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, brothers and sisters, the Bible lets us to know. He lets us to know in the book of Isaiah chapter 12, Isaiah 12, verse 2. He says, behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid. For yea, the Lord is my strength and song. He also become my salvation. Hallelujah. Meaning,
Amen.
Surely God is our Savior.
Hallelujah.
Great Master Jesus
Hallelujah.
Is our Savior. We trust in him, not to be afraid no more. Because what? He has become our Savior through his blood. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He's our Savior. But I tell you, brothers and sisters, he cannot become your Savior when you are not giving your life to Christ. He cannot become your Savior when you are not being sanctified by the blood of Jesus Christ. He cannot become your Savior when you are still dwelling in. You see where we just read in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 3 to 4. That we should avoid sin. We should avoid sin. We should avoid fornication, adultery. Wherever we have been sin on, we should make sure we avoid it from today. Because the blood and the body of Christ we are about to take, Jesus did this for sanctification in our life. He did this to save us. Not to sanctify his blood. To bring his blood on the cross so that we go and dwell in sin. No.
Mm-hmm.
He did it for we to be saved. He does not do it because a man carrying a goat to the shrine, when he slaughtered that goat, is of no use. He's of no use because he of no use in that shrine. He have no effect. For the blood of Jesus Christ is not so. But many of us today, we are taking the blood of Jesus like a blood of goats that have no effect. But I tell you, the blood of Jesus Christ, the Lord is telling us this hour, he came to sacrifice his blood so that we will be sanctified. And have salvation and be saved and return back home. That is why the blood of Jesus is active. It's very powerful. Whatever you use it for is so powerful. It's not a blood of goats that have no effect. Don't think so, brothers and sisters. If you are still having that low mentality, take it away now from today and the Lord will help you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So, you see, many of us that are still dwelling in evil, look at what we read very well. In 1 Thessalonians, that is where the Lord is pointing to us this hour. Because he said it is the will of God. It is the will of God in you, in man, in everyone. It is the will of God in our life that we should be sanctified. We should be sanctified. That is why he sent the Son. Help me to go and sacrifice your blood in the cross so that they will be sanctified by that blood and receive salvation and be saved and return back home. Do you say? But today many are not still saved. They are not still saved. They are still wallowing in the world, enjoying. Many are dwelling in sin. They are sleeping inside. They are enjoying it. The pastors out there, you see, they are right now. They are enjoying doing evil. They are even telling their member to be settled in sin. That there is no problem. Many are saying there is no hell. Why you will hear from the mouth of some that will say, there is no hell, but there is heaven. Look at you. A man said to me, I was on my way from traveling. I like being Christian. I saw the man in the train when I was returning back from traveling. I went for a ministration. Now, I met the man, glory be to God, the Lord was sharing the word. The man opened his mouth and said, there is no hell, but there is heaven.
Mm.
Immediately, he saw me, I keep him quiet for 2 minutes. He looked at me and looked his friend. I did not utter a word. He immediately said, hey, God forbid, oh, God have mercy on me. I said, hey, God has just have mercy on you. He's like, you know the thing, why I keep you silent? God just have mercy on you. You like a good thing, but you don't want to suffer.
Yeah.
He said, hey, what do you mean, sir? I said, you said there is no hell, but there is heaven. Mm. Oh, then you said there is no. Oh, then you said there is yes. His friend now look at me and say, ah, it's true. I said, nah, you said there is no hell, but you said there is heaven. You want to go to heaven. You like going to heaven, and you are not ready to receive Christ.
Mm.
You are not ready to be saved. And you know hell is full of fire. You don't want to go there.
Mm.
But you know heaven is full of enjoyment.
Mm.
You are saying there is heaven,
mm-hmm.
but there is no hell. But if now, the friend now say, ah, it's true. I say, if there is hell, if there is no hell, there is no heaven. Then, if you say there is heaven, that means there is hell. The other friend now say, ah, it's true, sir. That means there is also hell. Say, thank you. Thank you. If there is heaven, there is also hell. How can you say there is no hell, but there is heaven? You see, a man, this is how many of us are out there. We like a good thing. We want to enjoy, but we don't want to suffer. Many of us want God to help us. We run to God. Prophecy, God help me. God help me. Have you ever wake up and say, God, what do you want me to do for you this morning?
Mm-hmm.
Let him give you the portion he has for you. And so that you go forth and do it for him. Let he also be glorified. Instead of him sharing tears every day for your sin. Every day, many are still wallowing in sin. Jesus is crying every day. He's crying every day because the world does not know what he has come to sacrifice on the cross. He has not come what he comes to do with his blood. Why not ask Jesus, what do you want me to do for you, Lord? And I tell you, he has work for you. He will give you the work to go and do. So that he will also be happy and glorified in the kingdom. But today, what do we do to him? We are still nailing on the cross. We are still telling him his blood is not available. His blood is not worthy to shed. Brothers and sisters, let us begin to take away that low mentality away from us now. Because it's too much in the world right now. That low mentality is making ignorance, destroying the people right now. I tell you, ignorance is killing. He has been killing, he's still killing right now. And he will still continue killing many. Whoever refused to accept Jesus as personal savior, he will still continue killing them. So, brothers and sisters, the Lord can only be your savior when you have gave your life to him. If you are on this mountain this hour, you have not gave your life to Christ, please, I will allow you to raise up your hand and say with your mouth, I said, I am here. I want to give my life to Christ. So that the blood of Jesus you are about to take now, the body, all with the active. This is what Jesus has come to do. He has come to sacrifice blood on the cross so that you and I will be sanctified and receive salvation, meaning we'll be saved and return back home. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So you have given your life to Christ, you are still dwelling in sin. You see where we read. You are still dwelling in sin. You are not able to avoid sexual morality. You are not able to avoid sin. Hallelujah. You are not able to control your own body. Away from fornication and adultery, and make yourself to be holy and honorable before God. I tell you, you take this blood and this body cannot work in you. You have to come out now. That is the second category. You have to come at this hour and ask Jesus for forgiveness. Let him forgive you now, because the Lord is hammering 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 3 to 4. Look it very well, beloved brothers and sisters, and see what the Lord is saying there. And the Lord is saying, it is the will of God that you shall be sanctified. We in the world shall be sanctified. This is the reason he sent his son to come and sacrifice blood so that we will be sanctified and be saved. That you should avoid, meaning you should avoid sexual morality. Four is saying that you, meaning number four is saying that each of you, each of us shall learn, meaning we shall learn to control our body in a way that we keep ourselves holy and honorable. Great Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
That is where the Lord is right now. If somebody under the sound of my voice at this hour, you have never saved. You have been saved yesterday, but you don't know why the Lord saved you. You still go back to fornication and adultery. You are still going back to doing evil. The Lord is saying right now, the blood and the body. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So brothers and sisters, without wasting too much of our time, we have 2 minutes to do that. You are this mountain, under the sound of my voice, you are aware what the Lord is telling us this hour, so that he can save you through his blood and his body. He's ready to wash you now. If you are falling to sin yesterday because of the salvation, I tell you, you are not saved. He's no longer your savior. Because your salvation, it comes through the sanctification of what you have saved yourself. Today you are dwelling in evil. You are dwelling. I tell you, the salvation has been changed. And the Lord Jesus Christ is here to wash you again, to cleanse you with his blood. And I tell you, this hour you will be washed by the blood and the body you are about to eat. This is what Jesus is telling us, what we are about to take. What we are about to take so that we walk in our life. This is what he has come for. He came to sacrifice his blood on the cross so that you and I will be sanctified. To receive salvation and be saved and return back home. You are not saved. Your salvation will be polluted by sin. I tell you, you are not saved. You are not saved. You are only taking the blood and the body for taking sake. You are only fasting for fasting sake. I tell you, you are fasting for God. For all this to work right now, you put out your hand and say you are here. You are here, you have sinned against God. You know it in your heart. And you want to reconcile with him now. The Lord Jesus Christ is here to pray with you so that the blood and the body you will take, you will start walking, we wash you. And every spirit that will make you to go back again, not to control yourself away from sexual morality or evil, he will wash them away and make you holy and honorable before him this hour in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So you have 2 minutes to do that. Hallelujah. We have 2 minutes. Whoever is on this mountain this hour, Bible says, let who have ears hear what the Spirit is saying for the church. Hallelujah.